So you all know that you can communicate your learnings in lots of different ways. But in this community, we have to be able to communicate not just our learning, but everything. And in the world, we have to be able to communicate. And there are some communication barriers, or some people that might find it less easy to communicate than other people. I've asked some children to come up and help me. And these children have got different reasons why communication is perhaps not that easy for them. So let's start with Carmo. Now Carmo came to the school last year speaking Portuguese with no English. Is that right, Carmo? Well, you obviously understand that, and you obviously speak very good English now. I'm going to ask you two questions, and I want you to see if you can tell us the answers. What did you find was the most difficult thing about not speaking English when you came to BSB?
People to understand me and, like, seeing my emotions.
Okay, so Carmo found it very difficult to get people to understand her and to perhaps understand and appreciate her emotions. Okay, thank you, Carmo. How did you communicate to your friends and your teachers when you didn't speak any English?
By gestures and the language that I knew. And if I didn't pick up the thing, I would ask them for it.
Well, as you can see, Carmo, in 1 year, pretty much speaks fluent English now. And that's probably because your friends and your teachers and your parents really helped you. Is that right? So now you think you could go out and you probably understand most English, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Great, well that's great. Okay, thank you. So you now speak no English at the moment. Right, I had to use a friend. That was to be a millionaire, isn't it? I had to use a friend to ask the question, because I can't communicate. I could try, but Ignacio would probably get quite desperate with me. So, the question I'd like to ask Ignacio is, how do you manage to communicate to your classmates when you speak? So Thomas, could you please ask Ignacio this question?
¿Qué haces cuando quieres comunicarte con otras personas que solo hablan inglés?
He tries to talk a bit in English. And he also asks Sophia, who also speaks Spanish and English, to help her.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, Ignacio. Thank you. Now, Michael does speak English, but Michael has a different barrier. Michael does not hear as clearly as the rest of the children in here, or the rest of the adults. So communication is also quite difficult for Michael. But Michael has special spy ears, he calls them. And his spy ears help him to hear more clearly. But there might be different problems that Michael has now that he has spy ears. So let's ask Michael some questions. Michael, can you tell us one difficult thing about not hearing as clearly as other people?
Sometimes I make instructions because I don't hear that clearly.
So sometimes he misses the instructions because he's not hearing as clearly as everybody else. Okay, thank you, Michael. Tell us two things that your teachers have done to help you in your classroom.
The microphone, to make it a little bit louder to go in my spy ear.
Okay, a microphone. Is there anything else?
And a tennis ball to make those chairs stop squeaking.
Okay, so my tennis balls on the bottom of all the chairs in the classroom stop the chairs squeaking, and that stops that horrible sort of hissy loud noise in Michael's spy ears. Okay, one more question. Is there something we could do, us, all the children, and all of your friends, and all the teachers, to help you communicate better?
I look at my face when you're speaking to me.
Right. Thank you very much, Michael. Let's give him a big clap. This is the story of Helen Keller. Helen Keller was born in Tuscumbia in Alabama on June the 27th, 1880. She turned away from bright lights. She didn't hear people when they spoke to her. The illness had left Helen Keller blind and deaf. Soon her teacher taught Helen to read by feeling patterns of raised dots on paper. This kind of writing for blind is called braille. The reason I read you that story is that communication is such a huge part of everything we do, not just here in school, but out in the world. And just because you can't communicate the same way as everybody else, it doesn't mean you can't be as successful as everybody else. And these children here are a prime example. You can be as successful as everybody else if we all work together to help you to communicate.
So the first communication issue is Stacey. Second prefect this year is Sophia. Our third prefect this year is Sophie. Our next prefect this year is Reese. Boys and girls, let's give them a huge round of applause. Well done.